Welcome back to CBS This Morning. The Miami area has seen a 15% increase in tech professionals.
The mayor of Miami, Francis Suarez, how are you doing with regards to attracting more of those businesses to set up shop in Miami?
The idea of making Miami a crypto city was something that happened recently, but it's been really a 10-year build.
Miami's good at the hype. We're good at like the weekend and come in for the party, and there's a reputation.
Anybody who has a little bit of crypto can buy directly real estate.
We're gonna be the crypto capital of the world.
I am just a part of what's already been happening here.
I mean, it's the future.
Go Heat!
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Crypto Mondays Miami. Your DJ, he accepts crypto, so tip him in crypto.
We get drunk, we sing, and then people get more drunk, and then they sing more, and then they get more drunk, and everyone has a great time.
But we always sing about what?
Cryptocurrencies.
Everybody, this is the typical song that we open up with. This is a great song. It's really, really fun. Crypto Mondays in Miami, maybe 2017, because I wanted to find my tribe. Like, I wanted to find people that believed the same things that I did and saw the world moving in a way that was more decentralized. If you ask me why Miami, I'm gonna say we have a crypto community that is like, it's real. I'm gonna talk to you guys.
All the buildings that you see here, about 10 years ago, none of them existed. Miami is a very exciting time. We're just starting an evolution. Back in the days, in 2017, cryptocurrency transactions were things that would make headlines. You would see pretty much one every 2-3 months, and it was a huge headline. Now, we really see that it's a reality.
I'm Adam Rodolfi. I'm a managing partner and a global real estate advisor.
Welcome. We're in the heart of Brickell in one of the biggest penthouses here. Here you have the whole skyline of Miami. You're basically on the top of the world. It's a 6-bedroom, 6-bathroom. So this one is part of our penthouse collection that we offer in cryptocurrency. So the asking for this one is 7 million or as of today, 140 Bitcoin. Now we arrive in a 6-bathroom. Lots of space, as you see. Which is really what buyers are looking for right now. Because basically the new equation since the pandemic, you know, is no longer the location or the proximity to work. Really what people are looking for, quality of life, they're looking for space. And Miami has that to offer.
My name is Rob Weil. I'm a business reporter for the Miami Herald, specializing in technology coverage. So the interesting thing about Miami is there's a lot of new money here. Mayor Suarez really helped accelerate the process of Miami becoming a crypto hub. He famously tweeted last December, in December of 2020, when there was talk among Silicon Valley people about, hey, you know, San Francisco is not working out so great right now. What should we do? Someone suggested, hey, let's move Silicon Valley to Miami. And Mayor Suarez responded, how can I help? And that tweet really went viral, and Mayor Suarez was really there to welcome them with open arms.
The Miami area has seen a 15% increase in tech professionals.
The mayor of Miami, Francis Suarez, how are you doing with regards to attracting more of those businesses to set up shop in Miami?
The idea of making Miami a crypto city was something that happened recently, but it's been really a 10-year build.
Look,
I have two children. Technology's here to stay. For me, as you think about how do you create high-paying jobs which have a generational impact, you have to attract the people that create these companies.
Get her. How can I help? Our city CEO, mayor's office, which I won't say to that over there.
There's no question that what he has done here this year has just brought the community for this anchor point to everybody being able to jump in and celebrate this moment together.
Hello, my name is Mike Sarasti. I am the Chief Innovation and Information Officer of the City of Miami. Earlier in January, the mayor had proposed legislation to figure out how to do three things. One was to take payment for city services in Bitcoin. Two, potentially have employees get paid a portion of their salary. And the other one was the potential for the city to hold cryptocurrency on its balance sheet. At this point, I've got three, four paychecks that have been paid out. 10% of my salary is getting paid in Bitcoin. And I got, you know, it's been the highs and the lows as it is with Bitcoin, all of the volatility. But I can talk about that. And if we are as a city going to be, you know, publicly saying that like this is something that employees should look at, then you've got to do it. We want to create a model that's going to scale to multiple places.
Actually, what's amazing is the municipalities, the governments, they didn't have to spend a lot of money to attract people here. Florida has no income tax. We're an immigrant community, so people are trying to get in on the American dream.
Hey Ryan, how are you?
Hey,
good to see you.
Good
to see you. Thank you. So it's basically, since you're the only developer, the first developer who's accepting crypto.
Nine out of 10 views. So it's a Waldorf Astoria. It's 1,050 feet, and it's the tallest tower, residential tower south of New York. And we're nearing 60% sold. Cryptocurrency, which obviously is taking the world by storm. We wanted to be the first real estate developer to accept it for pre-construction projects. I mean, I think Miami is being touted as the crypto capital of at least America for now.
Go Heat!
Let's go Heat!
Americana, Airplane Arena was a very traditional name.
I fly American, but I like that they picked FTX. I like it.
It's a way to show how the world is changing because now all the crypto world is really growing a lot.
It's been awesome to have like my friends come into town and look at the arena that used to be the American Airlines arena and are looking up and like, FTX, what is that? And all of a sudden they're like, wait, this cryptocurrency stuff is real? It's like, yes, it's quite real. This is happening.
I think Miami is one possible outcome for the future of the entire industrialized world, which is becoming more sort of fractured.
The fact to be really a city who follows exactly the current economical trends is a huge green light for the next 5 to 10 years.
You know, I think back to the late 90s when I was first kind of getting into this space and the energy around like how the internet's gonna change the world. I'm feeling that level of excitement here again, and it's just the beginning. It's a lot of opportunity for this city.